Medicines and vaccines are different. Medicines are used to treat the disease, and vaccines are given to strengthen the body against the disease. You all may think that the vaccine may help to treat COVID-19, but it will prevent people from contracting the virus. American pharmaceutical company Johnson & Johnson has announced that after testing many vaccines for COVID-19, they have selected the lead vaccine candidate. The company says that the experimental vaccine is expected to go into human trials by September 2020 and might become available for emergency use by early next year. Johnson & Johnson CEO Alex Gorsky said, "We have been testing the vaccine a lot, and we are confident that the vaccine is safe and will be very effective." After doing all the tests, Johnson & Johnson expects to receive all its clinical data on the effects of the vaccine by the end of this year. If all goes well, then the vaccine may be ready by 2021. Gorsky said the company is pursuing the vaccine on a not-for-profit basis, but declined to estimate how much it might cost. Johnson & Johnson said that they are expanding their manufacturing facilities all over the world. Once the vaccine is ready, their aim is to produce and supply 100 crore doses. He also added that they have other backups in the case the lead candidate doesn't work well. Along with Johnson & Johnson, China's CanSino Bio are also racing to get the COVID-19 vaccine ready, with the human phase 1 trials ready. US pharmaceutical company Moderna is also making the vaccine and testing on humans. Even Israel has begun testing for vaccines. You remember I had explained about how a vaccine is used to prevent from the virus. Now, if a person has COVID-19, there is no medicine to treat it. Scientists are researching the use of malaria and AIDS medicines to treat COVID-19 patients. You all may think that how can AIDS medicines be used to cure COVID-19? Medicines used to treat AIDS only help to reduce pain and increase their life expectancy. Please remember, these medicines cannot cure COVID-19.